With drawing real animals, they had to adapt them into characters that could supply the range of expression and emotion needed to tell the story.
And you look at a deer, and boy, there are a lot of bumps and bones and muscles on there. Then you have to try to get expressions and attitudes. And I think Mark Davis was the guy who really opened up the door for us, showing us how you could get animatable expressions, human attitudes on a deer. Fantastic job. Without him, I don't think we ever would have made it.
One of the reasons that I came to the studio was that I was more or less expert in the drawing of animals. I took a huge book on baby behavior, and would go through, and every interesting child's face, I would interpret it into the mask of this young deer. And I think this was a turning point for the creation of the character.
A cute baby rabbit character was developed to give the story much-needed comedy relief.
I guess I had more fun with Thumper, and I liked his personality. He was so kind of precocious, always telling Bambi what to do, continually getting himself in trouble by saying the first thing that popped into his head.
Just eat the blossoms. That's the good stuff. Thumper?
So I liked the scene because that offered some good acting, and it offered a change of attitude. Because when his mother says, Thumper, what did your father tell you? Then he goes down, you know, about what, you know. Then, oh, that one.
Eating greens is a special treat. It makes long ears and great big feet. But it sure is awful stuff to eat. I made that last part up myself.
I like them for just as much today as I did then. It's really kind of fun having that as part of my life. As a four-year-old, I didn't read the copy. The way the recording was done was in a sound studio with a director, reading the lines with the inflection and the enthusiasm that they wanted. And then I did it back to them.
He doesn't walk very good, does he?
It was done numerous times until they got it just the way they wanted.
What did your father tell you this morning?
If you can't say something nice, don't say nothing at all.
Here in rare newsreel footage, we see a group of studio visitors watch as Frank Thomas animates a sequence with Thumper. Characters were animated using pencil drawings on paper that were then photographed to test the flow of movement and expression. Disney Studios' ink and paint department created all their own paints. For Bambi, nearly 250,000 cells were drawn and painted. When you combine that figure with the animation drawings, concept art, layouts, character designs, and backgrounds, over 1 million drawings went into making a little fawn come to life. Pretty amazing, isn't it, Bambi? To heighten the realism of Bambi, the multiplane camera was used extensively. By painting different layers of a scene on separate sheets of glass and moving them independently as they're photographed one frame at a time, flat art could create the illusion of depth. This opening sequence is an excellent example of the magic of the multiplane camera. When Bambi was first released in 1942, it was an immediate triumph and was recognized as one of animation's all-time greatest artistic achievements. Even now, over half a century later, Bambi continues to delight audiences. Perhaps because of its stark realism, it also lives on as one of childhood's most vividly memorable family classics.
We think that Bambi was Walt's favorite picture. All our features were different, but this one was the most different. The death of the mother is the one picture where somebody is really killed, and there's no fairy dust or lover's kiss to bring her back to life. She's dead. And I think that's the big thing that made this so different.
Bambi stands out as one of the first environmentally conscious films ever made. It shows that without responsible thinking, man can easily become the enemy of nature.
I'm a lover of nature. In fact, I respect nature very much. I feel that through watching, observing the habits of the creatures of nature, man could learn a lot.
The careless hunter's campfire almost destroys everything we've come to care about and serves as a valuable lesson for everyone to respect all of nature's creatures and habitats. Despite the inherent traumas and heartbreaks of the struggle for survival in the wild, Bambi and his friends give us a life-affirming example of the resilience of the spirit.
I think there's the happiness in it and the realism of the happiness. And happiness was not forced, they were not gagged, but they were things that you might find in your own family, in your neighbor's children, in your own children. And it just lived in your heart for years afterwards.